Roger was a rabbit who didn't have the rabbit habit. He felt that kind of thing was wrong. He said, oh no, when my love comes along. Peter Rodge the rabbit, when the chance came, wouldn't grab it. He said, though it may sound absurd, I believe that someone in the great somewhere hears every word. He had a higher moral code, and he didn't seem to know what manly skill meant. He said, unlike the horny toad, he was seeking for spiritual fulfillment. His brothers and his sisters were out exploring verdant vistas, but Roger wouldn't tag along. And through each long and lonely night, he stayed morally right. But being morally right for a rabbit can be wrong. Everybody has swinging. Poor little Roger the rabbit. All his friends used to jive and jeer at him, all because he didn't want to be petit bourgeois. His daddy used to take him across his knee. Not too easy for a rabbit to do it. He'd say, Roger, now hop to it. Roger, we had the family reputation to think of. Your mother is beside herself again, and don't you have any idea of what the neighbors are saying? Roger, owe some respect to your elders. You can't go around defying convention this way without doing irreparable harm to the family name. Roger, please. For our sake. Your sake? For God's sake. Go out there and prove you're not a man. So little Roger the rabbit promised that he would cohabit. He said, well, daddy must know best. A bird has got to fly, and a lemming, yes, a lemming must die. And a rabbit, yes, a rabbit has to pass his rabbit test. But where does one begin?